Hi, this is Ezekiel O'Callaghan with Raptor Chatter, here with my monthly reviews. This time, March 2018. Pterosaurs often have small, light bones that are very hard to fossilize because they break up so easily. Because of this, the Late Cretaceous has a lot of lacking fossils for pterosaurs, mainly as darkids have been found, the large, massive, giraffe-sized flying predators of the Late Cretaceous. However, there was a find announced this month coming from North Africa, showing multiple families of pterosaurs, including the Asdarchids, but also pteranodontids and nyctosaurids, two groups previously unknown from the Late Cretaceous. New evidence shows that Archaeopteryx likely flew like an awkward chicken. Using powerful x-rays, scientists were able to look at the bone structure of the bones before they had fossilized, and were able to deduce that based on their shape, it likely had a flight pattern that resembled that of modern-day partridges or wild chickens, which still fly quite well. If you were like I was growing up, you probably spent some time catching lizards, and sometimes you would notice that they would shed their tails to try and avoid being caught. This adaptation is called caudal autonomy, as it separates the bones in the vertebra from the tail in order to try and escape. A study this month shows that this adaptation goes as far back as the end Permian, specifically in Captorhinids, a group of early reptiles which lived during the period. This adaptation being so early shows just how key it was to the continued survival of reptiles while they were beset by larger synapsid and amphibian predators, and how we were able to get to our modern day reptiles that we recognize. Ceratopsians are well known for their diverse frill and horn shape, with some paleontologists suggesting that these evolved to help differentiate one species from other species that were living in the area. However, a new study suggests that is very unlikely the case. By looking at the morphology of the bones in the frill and of the horns, they found that it was far more likely that these frills and horns were used for interspecies communication and competition rather than strictly for just differentiating species, as has been seen in other places, such as modern-day animals with horns and antlers, who don't use it as differentiation, but rather competition. The eastern half of the United States is more widely known in paleontology for not housing very many fossils. However, that doesn't mean there aren't any. Specifically this month, Arkansaurus was announced, an Ornithomimid. This species was found in Arkansas, and helps to shed light into how the differentiation of species occurred in the eastern half of North America, when it was split during the Cretaceous by the Western Interior Seaway. The Megaraptorians are a group of dinosaurs of currently indeterminate origins, with some scientists having them come out of the Carcharodontosaurs, and others having them be very basal ceratopsians, and even potentially very basal tyrannosaurians. However, with such an indeterminate fossil record for them, it's hard to tell. But a new fossil helps to shed at least some light on it. An Argentine team has found the youngest, as far as the rocks are concerned, most recent to us, fossil of a Megaraptorian dinosaur, coming from 85 million years ago in Argentina. This fossil has the best preserved hips of the Megaraptorian dinosaurs, and so could shed light into how exactly they evolved and where exactly on the dinosaur family tree the Megaraptorians belong. And finally, brains. Specifically, brains that are 520 million years old coming from Greenland. This fossil shows preserved brain matter, which is actually rather different than what we see in modern animals. In modern animals, brains are composed of three main parts: the forebrain, the midbrain, and the hindbrain. This early fossil brain, however, shows a lack of these components, rather just having a singular mass composing of the whole brain. This helps to give insight into just how brains evolved and how we got to life that we have today. Hi everyone, thank you for watching. Really appreciate the support I've been getting. I do want to mention real briefly for news, Jurassic World Evolution was announced, and it's a park building game that was designed around Jurassic World. It's very similar, seemingly at least, to the old Jurassic Park Operation Genesis, which is one of my old favorite games from when I was a kid, so really excited about that. If you're interested in video games and dinosaurs, it might be something to look into. There are some scientific inaccuracies in it, but I'll cover those at some point. Just as a reminder, be safe, don't go extinct, and take care.